7.
6.
5.
4. 3.
2. 1. Hey everybody, it's George here.
And also Andrew.
And we're here for another episode of the Unnamed Kids Show.
For this episode, we are going to be talking about grace and mercy.
Oh, Andrew, did you know that I have a cousin named Grace and one of my best friend's sisters is named Mercy?
I did not know that.
Yeah.
I bet they're lovely people, but that's not quite what we're talking about. To help us out, here's a verse from the book of John.
Let's take a listen.
John 1:16. From God's fullness, we have all received grace upon grace.
Grace upon grace. That sounds like a lot of grace.
It is a lot of grace.
That's a good thing, right?
It is a good thing. I think what this verse is saying is basically God's grace is always there for us. It doesn't matter if we have moments where maybe we're mean, we mess up, maybe we keep making the same mistakes over and over again, God will always be there to forgive us.
Right, and it's important to note that it's a good thing to make sure that we let people know that we're sorry, right? When we mess up or we make mistakes, because that's a part of forgiveness. But through all of that, God's love is there for us.
That's right. So that's what we're talking about this episode. We hope you enjoy.
Oh, hey there, Andrew.
Hey, Georgie, how's it going?
Whoa, what are these? They look awesome. Why are their heads so wobbly?
These are bobbleheads. Bobbleheads are like collectible toys. A lot of folks have them. They could be animals, superheroes. You can even get a bobblehead of yourself.
What? A Georgie bobblehead?
That's right.
Oh, that'd be amazing! Hey Siri, add buy a bobblehead of myself to my shopping list.
Georgie, I don't think Siri heard you.
Yeah, well, I don't have a phone. I've just seen people do that on commercials and I didn't want to forget.
I'll help remind you later.
Oh, thanks big buddy. So, what kind of bobbleheads are these?
So these are baseball players, and actually a lot of them are from my favorite baseball team, the Chicago Cubs.
Oh. Nice, wow, they're so cool. And one guy's riding a bear.
Yep.
And another guy's blowing a bubble. Andrew, which one's your favorite?
Ooh, good question. I like them all a lot. Probably this one right here. This is my favorite baseball player. His name is Yu Darvish. And fun fact, most pitchers can throw maybe 2 or 3 pitches, fastball, curveball. This guy can throw 11 different pitches.
11 pitches?
Yeah.
That's awesome, wow. Hey, say, Andrew.
Yeah.
So, you think that maybe could I possibly borrow your Darvish bobblehead? I want to show it to my mom later and have her show me all of his different pitches on YouTube.
Yeah, that's fine. That's okay. Georgie, just make sure you're careful. I mean, they're kind of hard to find and it's my favorite bobblehead.
Oh, okay. I promise, Andrew. All right. Thank you.
No problem. Boing.
Oh, wow. That is the best couch to take a nap on here at church. But I better go get ready to meet Andrew. I just want to make sure I have all my things. Got my scarf, check, mittens, check, hat, check, pen, paper, check, cheese puffs, check, bacon, check, and the Yu Darvish bobblehead, check. Wait, the Yu Darvish bobblehead, where did that go? Where is it? I thought I had it. Let me look again. Oh no, it's not in there. Where did it go? Where did I put it? Siri, where is Andrew's Yu Darvish bobblehead? Oh, that's still not working. Okay, just think, Georgie. Okay, just retrace your steps. Think about where you went with it and where you last took the bobblehead. Okay, yes. First, I went to my favorite sledding hill. And then I went to Sky Zone and jumped on some of the trampolines. And then I went to the Mall of America and rode all the rides. Yep, that was really fun. Okay, and then I came home and played my drum set. Yep. Oh, and then I tried some trick shots for my YouTube channel. And then I went to bed. Ugh, well, that didn't work. I'm here now, and I still don't know where it is. Ugh, what am I gonna do? That was Andrew's favorite bobblehead. Oh, no. Oh, hey there, Whuppet friends. Hey, Flash and Hurry and Torny. How are you? Hey, have you seen Andrew yet? Okay, well, I'm in a little bit of a pickle. I may or may not have lost his most favorite bobblehead, and I can't find it anywhere, and I don't know what to do. Yeah, I've looked in my backpack. Yep, I've retraced my steps. Did I look under my armpit? Well, no, but I don't think it's there either. Ugh, what do I do? Andrew's always so helpful and kind, but what if he's really mad at me this time? What if he doesn't want to be my friend? What if he doesn't want to film the Unnamed Kids Show together and I have to be Georgie and Andrew at the same time on camera? Oh no, what am I going to do? Oh, well, while you were doing a really good job of pretending to be bobbleheads, I think he knows what the real one looks like. You really think he'll believe me if I tell him while I was sledding, I was struck by a bolt of lightning and the U-Darvish bobblehead flew from my hand and it was never to be seen again? Yeah, I don't think so either. Well, I don't know, Hurry. We don't really live by the ocean. I don't think he'll believe me if I tell him I was swept up in a hurricane. Torny, I don't think there have been any tornadoes recently either, so that one's out too. You really don't think he'll forgive me, Hurry? I know people aren't always that great at forgiving. You know, puppets aren't that great either. God is really good at forgiving, but you really think God's the only one that can forgive me? Oh no, what am I gonna do?
Hi families, why don't we stand up from where you're sitting, so away from your chair or your table or your couch, and find an open space. And why don't you join us with some stretches and some movement. We're gonna do a few winter poses. And so our first one we're gonna try is our skiing pose. So some of you maybe have gone skiing this winter. And so what we're gonna do is keep our feet together. You're gonna bend your knees like sitting in a chair. And then you can either keep your arms out or we can also try ski jumps where we can kind of like, you know, jump side to side a little like this. So after you try that a few times, we can freeze. We can try to balance again. Maybe just kind of stand still as you can. It's a little tricky. And then we'll move on to our second one, which is our tree pose. And a lot of our trees are still kind of covered in snow. So what we'll do is try to stand on one foot or try to balance and hold as much as you can. And you can stand and try to keep your arms like up high, maybe stretch up as high as you can. Try to hold it if you can. Yeah, just like that. And if that leg gets tired, you can also switch legs too. Yeah, there we go. There we go. After you try that, why don't we do our last pose, which is an ice skating pose. And so maybe you've gone ice skating a little, it's a little tricky. And so what we can do is try to stand on one foot again, but this time stick your leg out behind you. And if you want, maybe you can turn to the other side. You could also keep switching other sides. There we go, try both sides. And then, you know, if that's kind of fun to do too, sometimes people like to jump on like ice skates or just jump around. So we could jump on one foot and jump on the other foot. Yeah, so a couple movements there. So if you want, you can try those again if you'd like to. But if you're all stretched out, you can sit back down and finish the rest of our show.
Oh, hey, Georgie, how's it going?
Hey, you had a busy yesterday. I was looking at your Google Calendar. You went on some roller coaster rides. You were filming some trick shots for your YouTube channel, Puppet Perfect. How was that?
Oh, yeah, it was good. Thanks for asking.
Yeah, what was your favorite part of the day?
I guess all of it was my favorite part.
Okay. Georgie, usually you tell me all about your day in great detail every time we hang out. You're not acting yourself. Are you okay? What's wrong?
Oh, you know, just feeling down about how we should save the whales.
Save the whales? Georgie, did you go on a rabbit hole again on YouTube? We talked about this.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I promise I'll do anything to make it up to you.
Georgie, hey, it's okay. It's okay. It's all right. It's all right. Hey, Georgie, it's important to take care of animals, but I don't really blame you for the whale population.
No, Andrew. I'm talking about you, Darvish. Oh.
You, Darvish, is causing whale extinction?
No, Andrew. You're you, Darvish bobblehead. I lost it. I had it yesterday, but I can't find it anywhere in my room, and I even retraced my steps. I'm so sorry!
All right, I got it.
And Andrew, I'm sure you're mad at me and never want to see me again because you told me it was your favorite bobblehead, and I still lost it, and you can lose one of my favorite toys to make it fair, okay?
Hey, Georgie. It's okay. I forgive you.
Well, my favorite toy right now is this remote control monster truck that I really love, but you can lose that if you want, and... Wait. Andrew, what did you say?
Georgie, I don't want to lose one of your toys. I said, it's okay. I forgive you.
You're not mad at me?
No, I'm not mad at you. I mean, obviously, I wish the bobblehead wasn't lost, but mistakes happen. I know you didn't do it on purpose.
Well, you still want to be friends with me?
Of course I still want to be friends. I can always get another bobblehead, but Georgie, I can't find another Georgie.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Andrew. I'm really glad you're my friend.
I am too.
I feel so much better. See, I was talking to the Wuppets earlier, and Hurry thought there was no way you'd forgive me because people aren't very good at it. And then Torny said that she thought only God was good at forgiving.
Okay, I gotta rewind a little bit, Georgie. Who are the Wuppets?
Well, they're my weather puppet friends.
Got it. All right, yeah, I'll have to meet Torny and Hurry someday.
And Flash.
And Flash, too. I think the Wuppets make a great point. One of the ways that God loves us is through grace. And grace just means God's gonna forgive us, you know, no matter what we've done. We could have been mean, make a mistake, maybe do the same hurtful thing over and over again, but God's gonna forgive us.
Wait, God doesn't care if we're mean, Andrew?
That's not quite what I mean. God cares about us. God wants what's best for us and everybody else. So God does care if we're not doing that. But as long as we're sorry, and as long as we're trying to make things right again, God's love isn't gonna change.
Wow, that's like big time love. But apparently people aren't very good at forgiving.
Some people are. Some people are really good at it. And for others, it's not so easy. Like for some people, it's really hard to forgive themselves when they've messed up.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's totally me. Whenever I make a mistake, I can't help but think about it for like a really long time.
Yeah, that makes sense. We can be our own toughest critic. And for some other people, it's hard to forgive others. Maybe the hurt was really big and it just takes time. Whatever the case, God's with us as we figure out what grace looks like in our lives.
Wow. Thanks, Andrew. This was really helpful. And again, I'm sorry for losing your you, Darvish bobblehead.
It's right, Georgie. Hey, I've got an idea. How about you show me some of those trick shots you filmed yesterday on your YouTube channel?
Oh, yeah, good idea. I had this one where I was upside down hanging from a branch and I had a piece of bacon dangling from my mouth and Flash was driving my remote control monster truck underneath me. And then there was this other one where I was inside of my house and I was doing pots and pans and ping pong balls and...
It's hard to forgive someone when they say sorry because you know they might do it again.
It's not really easy because they're the one who've done something wrong. They make you mad, then you don't want to say sorry because they made you mad.
When I'm upset, I sometimes do this square breaths like this. And when I'm upset, I usually push against the wall.
Hey there, Cissé.
Hey, George.
So friends, we're here with our good friend Cissé. And Cissé, you play music in the alternative service, right?
Yes, I do.
And you play elsewhere around the cities as well?
All the time.
Oh, that's awesome. Cissé.
Yeah.
What do you love about playing music?
Oh, lots of things. First of all, I want to say music is one of those things that's a universal language. And any way you go in the world, people play music. And it's just one way to connect with people. And that's what I love about it.
Wow. Yeah. That's really cool, Sisei. I love that. Sisei, do you have a favorite song that you like to play?
You know, George, a lot of times when I'm with friends, there's a song called Lean On Me that I love to play because it just connects with people and it brings us together. And it's about friendship, you know?
Wow. Hey, Sisei?
Yeah.
Do you think that maybe you could play that song for us right now?
You know what? That sounds like a great idea, George. Why don't we do it? Why don't you join me? You can sing along too.
Okay.
This is Lean On Me. Here we go. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrows. But if we are wise, we know that there is always tomorrow. Sing it, lean on me.
Lean on me.
When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
You sound so good, Sisei.
Yeah. So now you can sing along with me if you know the next verse. All right, here we go. It starts with please, okay? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Please. Swallow your pride. If I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs.
Yeah.
That you won't let your sing it, lean on me. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend.
I'll be your friend.
I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Clap your hands.
You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand, cause we all need somebody to lean on. Cause I just might have a problem. Whoa. That you don't understand.
That's awesome.
We all need somebody to lean on.
Sing it, lean on me.
Lean on me. When you're not strong.
When I'm not strong.
I'll be your friend.
I'll be your friend.
I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Beautiful.
If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, I'm right up the road. I'll share your load if you just call me.
Sing, call me.
You got to call me when you need a friend. Call me when you need a friend.
Call me
when you need a hand.
Call me.
Say, call me, hold it.
Call.
Take a deep breath, George. Say me on the count of 3, 1, 2, 3. Good job, George.
Wow.
Sisei, yeah.
Thank you so much. That was so special.
You're welcome, George. Anytime.
Thanks, Sisei, so much for sharing your gifts and your music with us today. You know, maybe you out there are like Sisei. When you're processing or going through things, you like to sing or play an instrument. Or maybe you like to be outside, go on a walk in the woods.
Do some crafts,
right?
Yeah, totally.
Painting, art. There are so many different ways to process our healing.
That's right. And even though God's grace and mercy is always there for us, as people, it's a little more complicated, mm-hmm. right? Maybe you're ready to ask for forgiveness right away. Maybe you're ready to forgive someone right away. And sometimes you're not. It might take time. You might need to find ways to heal. You might need to find ways to process. And all of that is okay. God is in all those spaces.
So we hope that you know that you are so loved, you are so special, and that you have so much light to give to this world. We can't wait to see you for another episode of the Unnamed Kids Show coming up here soon. We'll see you soon.
See you next time.
Bye.